Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope you all are doing great. So in this video, I'm going to show you 10 types of rubber plant. Okay, so far I've collected 7 types. I'll show them to you one by one, including their name. And also at the end of the video, I will show you the remaining 3 that I have not collected yet. Okay, so now, the one that you're looking at here, this one, this is called Robusto. Okay, it has a dark green leaf. Look at this, very waxy, glossy, beautiful leaf, very soft, nice. You see, very suitable for indoor. All rubber plants are suitable for indoor. If you keep them indoor in a right size pot, it can grow up to 2.5 meter. You can also grow this outdoor. If you grow outdoor, it can grow up to 30 to 40 meter. But this is not suitable for keeping near house because the roots are very vigorous and can invade the piping system or the sewage system. Okay, so if you want to, you plant it far away from your home. Okay, but it's a very good plant for outdoor, for blocking the sunlight and providing natural shade. It has a white canopy. Okay. Look at this, very beautiful. This plant is a little bit old. I've used this plant to do a lot of cuttings and replanting. Okay, as you can see, I show you one here in this pot. Can you see this? This is a 5 weeks old. I took the cutting from this plant. This is my mother plant actually. See this? See this new leaf, how beautiful, shiny. The bottom of the plant is like this. This is also a new leaf. Okay, this is what will grow into a leaf. It's a very strong plant. If you're planting by cutting, it does not need any staking. You can just straight away plug it into a soil, a well-drainage soil. Okay, does not this is not suitable to grow in a soggy water holding soil. Okay, make sure you have a good potting mix that can drain the water properly. This is Belize. See how beautiful it is, purple color. Okay, in the beginning, when the leaf is coming out, okay, it will look like this. With green behind is pink color. Okay, this plant is still young. Okay, hope in the next 6 months it can actually grow at least up to 1 meter. Okay, see. Now this one is called Abidjan. I hope I pronounced that correctly. If I am pronouncing any wrongly, please let me know. But, and also if the names I'm telling here is wrong, please share with me in my comment. This is the name that I know. As far as I know, I believe this is the true name that I'm, the correct name I'm giving you. This is Abidjan. Abidjan is a bit different. The leaves are not white. It is actually long. If you compare to this one, see, Robusto and also Belize, the width of this particular leaf, okay, normal, this one is long, wider compared to Abidjan. Abidjan has a long leaf like this. It's also glossy and waxy, but it has a long leaf. It's also a new plant, okay. It's actually newly planted. There's a 3 cuttings there, you can see. Just cut like this and you can just plug it into a soil and then plant it, okay. This one variegated. I just love this one. I love the color. It has white, yellow, light yellow that looks like white color. It's a variegated one. Some people call this, if I'm not wrong, Sylvia. Okay, I hope I got the name correctly for this one. There's too many types. You know, sometimes you just don't know which is which. You may attempt to get the names correctly. If I'm telling the names wrongly, as I mentioned just now, please share with me the correct name. So this is variegated. Okay, this is the new leaf, how it looks like. Look behind. Behind is like behind. Okay, this one behind the leaf will have a hint of pink purple color like this, as you can see here. See how beautiful this one, glossy. Okay, this one is called Altissima, if I'm not wrong. Okay, I hope I'm telling Altissima, Altissima Golden, I think so. Okay, it is this one is one of the largest leaves that I've seen, okay, in this particular rubber plant variety. Okay, you can see how huge. Okay, see my hand there. My hand is about longer than 7 inch. I mean my fingers and together like this. So you see how long this one. This is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's about 10 inch long. The leaf is about 10 inch long. Okay, it has dark green, light yellow, very beautiful, very shiny, soft, almost fluffy. I just love this particular plant. Okay, the color is so beautiful. The bottom, it looks like this, the color, the green color. Okay, so nice. It's like, it feels like touching an animal. It's really it's very soft, very nice. Very nice. This one is burgundy. You can see burgundy also very tall. This is about 10 to 12 inch. Okay, I believe if the plant grows taller and bigger, the leaf can, the size can grow bigger. I love this burgundy. See this. So beautiful. Behind the new leaf is pink color, pink red. The old leaf also dark purple like that. The patterns are like this, you can see closely. Now if you compare the burgundy and also this one, okay, the patterns are a bit different on the leaf there. You can see something like a crack patterns here, but this one is very smooth patterns. Okay, so even though they are from the same species, okay, rubber plant, Ficus elastica, but the pattern appearing on this, the nerve patterns appearing on the leaf is actually a bit different. Okay, you can see some of it here, like on this one, Abidjan, and also here, the patterns are a bit different, you can see. Okay, this pattern is very obviously different. Okay, look at this. Now this one is known as Thinike. I hope Thinike or Thinike, I'm not very sure. I hope I pronounce it correctly. This is about 1/2 meter tall. Okay, I've been having this for quite some time. I haven't got a bigger pot, so I'm still keeping it in a poly bag. See, show you the leaf in a close-up. See how beautiful the leaf. See the pink color behind. See, beautiful pink color. They are so beautiful. So all rubber plants are so beautiful. So I've shown you Robusto, I've shown you Belize, okay, and I've shown you Abidjan. This is the variegated. Okay, this is the golden lemon, Altissima, I think so. I think that's the name for this. And I also shown you the burgundy, okay, and this is Thinike. So these are the 7 plants that I have at the moment. The remaining 3 that I don't have, okay, they are known as one is Safari, the other one is Decora, the last one that I don't have yet is called Shrivariana, I think. Shrivariana, if I remember correctly. I hope to collect these remaining 3 as well. Okay, once I have them, I'll show them to you as well in the real one. By the way, if you are planning to grow this, keep this plant indoor, make sure you keep them by the window so that they can get plenty of sunlight. Even though this plant can be grown indoor without a lot of sunlight, if you want them to be healthy and grow taller, it's best to give them enough of sunlight. Okay, so putting them beside window is the best suggestion I can give you. Okay, as you know, this is a tropical plant, so yeah, sunlight is very important. And also don't overwater them. The roots does not do well in soggy water. Make sure the soils are dry before you water them. Okay, how you can test them is by touching the soil. If you touch the soil and if you find the soil is dry, yes, then you can water the plant. If the soil is not dry, just leave it, don't water it again. Okay, now another important thing about this plant is that this plant contains white color latex like sap. Okay, this can be very toxic to small animals like cats or small dogs, so also for young children. So if you have toddlers or like young kids that, you know, like to pluck the leaves, you know, if they accidentally put in their mouth, okay, this can be dangerous. Okay, can cause vomiting or nausea if ingested. All right, so be careful. If you have small kids or children at home or small animals, okay, so this won't be a good plant to keep indoor. Okay, and another feature that I can share that I love about this plant is that this plant has it is able to get rid of this particular thing called as if I remember correctly, this is called, wait, let me think, I forgot the name. Yeah, it is called formaldehyde. Now I got it. So formaldehyde is actually a volatile organic compound found in resins and adhesives. So if you have people coming home doing a renovation, you know, they've been cutting plywoods or chipboards. So this chemical actually, this compound actually comes out from these particular things. So having this plant will be a good idea because they can actually remove that particular compound. Okay, so that's some things that I think you should know about this plant. Okay, I hope I didn't forget anything. And for you, those who are watching this video, if you have any tips, please do share in the comments so other viewers can benefit also. Let's learn together and take care of this plant. Okay, so I hope the tips I've given you and also these plants can inspire you to get one. Okay, so yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in another video. Have a nice day.